Charlevoix, Michigan is a popular tourist town with a long tradition of successful summer Venetian festivals. The week-long celebration has events for everyone. The festival is a homecoming for returning native families along with visitors from all over the Midwest. The week is filled with nightly music in the Performance Pavilion, two nights of fireworks, a boat parade, 18 different sporting events that are called the Venetian Games, climaxed with a popular street parade through the main street of downtown Charlevoix, preceded by the men's and women's Shay mile race. In only 3 years, this race has gained national prominence. Organizer and originators Douglas Bergman and Matt Peterson convinced festival planners that a mile race through the streets of Charlevoix could be logistically possible.
I guess what our objective with this is A, it's a honor and a tribute to Ryan, but I guess second would be just that really our objective is just to create a quality national and potentially even a world-class event.
We'd like to make it the premier road mile in the United States. That would be the goal, and to continue to make it a fitting tribute to Ryan Shay.
Well, it's just a great event for the town. It's, you know, it's up north. You know, it's the up north flavor, and you know, the kind of the town fair atmosphere, and you know, road miles are you know, it's a good break for a person like Nicole, you know, getting off the track, and you know, it's still competition, so it's a lot of fun.
But this year, I hear they have 8 people that are under 4 minutes that have run under 4 minutes in a mile, so. This might be the best mile I've ever seen in my life. I've seen a few good ones, but this might be the fastest mile I've ever seen. And on the women's side, I guess they got a real good field also. So really looking forward to the Ryan Shay Mile. Great cause, too. I think I just talked to Joe Shay over there. Wonderful cause. I'm glad that they're able to raise the funds there off of this deal.
Very good for Charlevoix, obviously. You know, coming up to this beautiful little town. You know, they have all these basically world-class milers come up and run right into the town right before the parade is phenomenal, you know. The men's field this year has got 20 really good runners, and the women's field's getting better also and has, I think, 9 real good runners. Great for Charlevoix, great for Michigan, and I mean, where else would you want to be in summer besides Charlevoix, you know? So, very excited.
Former Charlevoix resident, I think it's great. I mean, the event has grown tremendously thanks to Douglas Bergman's efforts and Matt Peterson's efforts. It's a great venue. It should be a lot of fun. Always the competitiveness. It doesn't matter how fast they run. If there's a bunch of people close at the end, it's always exciting.
Well, it helps preserve the memory of our son, Ryan. When Jeff and Doug and Douglas and Matt came to me in the winter before the first run, that was their goal. And they've done a first-class job of keeping this race alive in memory of my son.
I read somewhere, and I can't remember where, that this is becoming one of the most renowned one-mile road races in the nation.
It also shows off Charlevoix, which we're really proud of.
I want to explain just a little bit, if I may, in regards to the Ryan Shay Mile. Ryan Shay was a state champion in track and cross country in both high school and in college. He was an All-American, an NCAA running champion at the University of Notre Dame, and a national champion professional runner. Additionally, he was an honor student in both high school and college. Most of all, Ryan was a true Northern Michigan native who's trained on many of the roads not far from here. Last year we referred to it on the radio station as the Elite Mile, because what you have is world-class milers here about to run a drag race. Normally a drag race runs a quarter mile, folks, but this one, you're gonna see some supercharged motors run down through here because it's in a straight line. So it should be a great time.
It's a different feel, it's a different course. It's not like a track race, which I think everybody's used to. And I would say, you know, be careful of the hill. The metal zaps your legs a little bit once you get to the bottom of it. I mean, it's not so steep that you're going to fall or anything, but it's steep enough to where you'll get to the bottom and you'll feel a little dead. So the last quarter mile is pretty interesting. A lot can happen in the last quarter. been up here a couple times before, just on vacation, so I've always liked this area, and the course is really cool. The way the last half mile was, you know, the crowd started to pick up and the cowbells and everything. And the hill was a change of pace, so I liked it a lot. It's different.
Ryan passed away in November of 2007 while competing for a spot on the United States Olympic team in the marathon. Although Ryan is no longer with us, his spirit will most certainly live on and drive those to pursue excellence in athletics and otherwise.
My main focus was when I came over the hill, I could see the finish line banner. So from the second that it was in my view, that's all I focused on. Very exciting and fun to compete in and be a part of. And if you bookend it with, you know, a great host family and they're so friendly, then there's no place I'd rather be on weekend in July.
You know, Charlevoix is a great area to spend the weekend. I'm here with my family and some friends, and you know, we love the little downtown area. There'll be the fireworks tonight, and it's just a great Venetian festival. It's a good time.
As you talk to the runners, you can tell that they love this event. And I think it's a combination of Matt getting great host families so that the runners stay overnight and enjoy the location and the beauty of this wonderful city of Charlevoix. And then to have such an outstanding event with a crowd of literally tens of thousands of people cheering them on, it can't be duplicated. And what we hope is this thing can grow, and who knows, eventually it could even be a television event on a slow Saturday at 11 o'clock. It kind of concludes our whole array of Venetian games. We have 18 other sports that go on all week, and this is sort of the climax of it, so it couldn't have been better.